Hi everyone, Azriel Knight here, and today we're going to talk about how agitation frequency affects your final image. Last time I did an experiment, it was on agitation speed. And if you haven't seen that video already, I think you'll be really interested in the results, and I'll make sure and leave a link in the description below. Now I'm going to take you into the studio and show you my camera setup. Just like last time, I'm going to fill an entire roll of film with the same picture. Okay, so here's my setup, pretty simple. I got the cast of the Next Generation hanging out right there. So pretty much I'm going to be metering with my handheld light meter there. I'm just going to be using the modeling light to expose the figures. I'm using my sharpest lens, the Sigma 50mm 1.4, and I'll be using a roll of Kodak Tri-X 400. Okay, now that I've taken the same shot 36 times, I'm gonna split this roll into three separate developing tanks. I'm gonna do my best to keep everything consistent except for one factor, and that's the frequency in which I agitate the film. Not the speed like last time, but how often I do it. In tank number one, it's gonna be a stand development at regular time. So in this case, Tri-X 400 at its box speed is going to be a 6-minute development at 68 Fahrenheit. And in the first tank, I'm not going to agitate at all. I'm just going to pour it in, tap it a couple times to get the bubbles out, and then pour it out at the end. Tank number two, I'm going to agitate as normal. And then tank number three, I'm going to agitate the entire time without stopping. Okay, I split the film into three separate strips and put them into their tanks, and now I'm ready to make the developer. So again, different from last time, I'll be making three separate batches of developer and making sure that the temperature is consistent for each one. I'll just be really careful with the ratios. Yeah, I just feel like if the ratios are off, that's going to do more than the temperature. Maybe that's an experiment for another time. Yeah, I'm going to create three separate developers and just keep everything as close as possible, and I think that'll produce better results than if I had a dropping temperature in my developer as I went through like last time, where it was 71, 68, and then 67, I think. Yeah, so we'll do it separate this time. Unless I make the whole batch at once, and agitate the other two at the same time, because I don't have to keep any sort of crazy memory game. The first one, I don't agitate at all. The second one, I agitate as normal. And the third one, I just agitate the whole time. So as long as I'm quick with my hands, I should be able to develop all three with the same ratio at the same temperature. Awesome. I'm gonna make the developer a couple of degrees warmer than it needs to be, so I've got time to take care of anything that I need to before I pour it in. I have pre-wash sitting in all three tanks right now, and the developer is at 71 Fahrenheit, so I got about 3 degrees to go before I dump it in here. But my plan is pretty much to start the timer, dump in the first batch, and then the second and third, and then start agitating the second and third for a minute, and then continue with this one just like the whole time, and this one as normal for 10 seconds at each minute. That reminds me, I'm gonna need about a liter of stop bath. Okay, everything's set up and ready to go. It's at about 69 Fahrenheit. But what's more important than getting the temperature spot on is making sure that the temperature is the same on each. And because I made this batch together, the ratio is going to be identical throughout. This will be the closest I can get it with my current setup. I think it's pretty good. I think we're good. Now I just have to pour out the pre-wash and pour on the developer and get started. I'm a little nervous because I want to make sure I get my timing right, but I think everything will be okay. Okay, I think I got the development times pretty spot on. Now all three tanks are sitting in a stop bath solution and I'm about to fix it. I didn't end up cleaning my negatives properly last time, and it sort of gave me some issues while I was scanning. So this time I am gonna make the effort and do a proper wash. Okay guys, all the film is fixed. I rinsed the hell out of it and put it in some photo flow. I'm gonna let it sit for a few minutes, then we're gonna see the results together. Okay, I've let them soak in the photo flow for a few minutes just for good measure, and now I'm ready to open up the first tank. This first tank here was the stand development. I literally poured the chemicals in and then poured it out again. Again, with nothing to compare it to, who's to say? I'm gonna hang this one up and check the next one. Okay, next one I'm opening up is normal agitation. That's agitation for the first minute and then 10 seconds for every minute after. This one looks like it has more contrast. Okay, we're actually seeing results this time, fantastic. Okay, first two strips are hanging up there. And here's the final tank, which I agitated for the entire 6 minutes. I'm really, really curious to see what we find here. That looks darker than the rest. That definitely looks darker than the rest. Like, it's not earth-shattering, but I am seeing a difference this time. Maybe it's psychosomatic, maybe I'll get to the scanner and I'll find that no, there's no difference. So the next thing to do now is just to get these things dry and then on the scanner. Okay, the negatives are dry. I stuck them on the light table. Let's have a look. Okay, even from back here, you can see that the non-agitated strip is very different from the regular agitated strip. There is a difference between the regular agitation and the constant agitation, but we're gonna have to look closer for that. Here's a sample from the stand development. This sample is from standard agitation, and here's one from constant agitation. I'm gonna scan these into the PC now and have a closer look. When I initially scanned my images, I found that they looked pretty similar, more similar than they did on the light table. And I figured that even with almost everything turned off on the scanner software, it's still gonna sort of auto-correct. So the only way I could go around that was to cut a single negative from each strip, put them side by side on the scanner, and not highlight them at all, just scan the entire thing. So here are the results from that. You can see with no agitation, it's really bland. The blacks aren't black, and the highlights aren't white. With normal agitation, it's just that normal. Interesting how the consistent agitation method, to me at least, looks the best. I just thought that was interesting. But again, you see that there is more contrast. So there you have it. Increasing your agitation frequency will increase the contrast in your final image. So in this case, I use Kodak Tri-X 400 and HC110 Delusion B. Depending on what film and developer you use, your results will vary. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, stay classic.